Hey guys and girls, welcome back to another edition of Let's Beat the Snot Out Of. Now, today, it's a very good day. Main reason is because Hazzard, the person who created that lovely GQ Nissan Patrol long wheelbase that I like so much, has released a Range Rover. So yesterday you would have seen me beat the snot out of, I think it was Shark 777's Range Rover Sport. Well, Hazzard has released a Range Rover Classic, a 1990 Range Rover Classic. So we're going to whack that on the Rally GP map and we'll see how it goes. I've got to find it. See, I got lots of trucks. It's a good thing. Variety is the spice of life, after all. So let's grab the classic Range Rover, let's whack it in the Rally GP map, and let's go. First things first. Wow. Look at the details on this bad boy. Nice. Not as crisp as Shark 777's. Shark 777's Range Rover Sport, the body details were a little bit cleaner, a little bit sharper. After all, this is a 1990 Range Rover. For some reason, Hazzard decided to put rusty wheels on it. Not sure I would have gone with that. But anyway, we don't get any add-ons, but we do get the option of installing military spec tires, which make it a little bit more agricultural, a little bit more farm truck. So let's go back to the default, which looked pretty good. The tread pattern at least looks really good. Get rid of that. Now, before we start, I'm going to make sure that our volume is down, because if I remember, Hazzard uses a nice chunky sounding V8. If it's the same V8 that's in the Nissan Patrol, it's going to be loud. So let's find out. Yep, same lumpy V8. Let's have a look. We get headlights, that's good, that works. Do we get brake lights? Yep. Get reverse lights. Yes, full points. Okay, now a little bit about the truck. We get 250 litres of onboard fuel and we get 1,000 points of damage. Okay, let's fuel her up. Let's head off into the trail. First things, steering seems pretty good. It's not too fast, but it's not too slow either. And it just went straight over that section in two-wheel drive, where others get stuck in the four-wheel drive. So that's a good start. Just click the edge of that rock. Let's turn it into the trail and see how we go in two-wheel drive in the mud. Now, I don't think this is going to be as capable as the Nissan Patrol. Main reason being is the wheelbase is a little bit shorter. Yeah, it's moving through the mud in two-wheel drive, but not as good as what the Patrol did. So let's give it diff lock and all-wheel drive and we'll keep moving. Didn't see any high water level coming on there. Straight over the rocks, no problems at all. Okay, let's spin the camera around to the front as always so we can watch it drop off. Okay, let's go. Now, is it going to tail bash? Don't know. Front's in. No! Not really, not enough to damage it. Okay, we'll go through. Alright, let's bring that camera around to the front so we can see how much suspension travel we've got on the front end. A little bit. Not excessive, but enough. Oh boy. This could go wrong very quickly. Oh, nice work, nice work. Good recovery. Okay, let's get it into the water. Okay, that water limit seems to be equal where the head of the driver would be. So river crossings shouldn't be an issue. So we get the dangerous water level, but I'm not copping any damage from it yet. So it's about equal with the driver's head. It's a little bit higher up than a bonnet, but still, handy level to have. Now, it's not a particularly wide vehicle, so I'm not having any problems on the skinny section here. It's not terribly tall, so we shouldn't get on that log up above. Just get it up and over that boulder. Turning it into a paddle steamer for some reason. Coming around, bringing it up and out. Now this is where we come to the log bridge. So let's get it across the log bridge. Okay, let's go. Now I don't know how this is going to go on the log bridge. Is it going to glitch through, or will it ride on top with style? Can't really see. It looks like it just went straight on. No worries, look at that. No safety winch needed. Beautiful work. Okay. Downhill brakes are really good. That's top mark on the brakes there. Alright, up and out. So this is definitely no speed machine. Okay, final thoughts. Well, it's a great looking mod, and as I first thought, due to the slightly shorter wheelbase, it's not as capable as the Nissan Patrol. Still a very capable vehicle in itself, don't get me wrong. There's one thing I would have liked to have seen. Instead of the exhaust coming out here, it would have been nice to get that classic Range Rover twin tip coming out the side here. But that's just being nitpicky. That's being very nitpicky. Yeah, great vehicle, great mod, great to drive. Yeah, there's not much else I can say about it except, well done, Hazzard, another great mod. Yeah, the wheels I'm not too crash hot on. It would have been nice to have seen maybe some more like era specific rims like that you would actually see on a Range Rover. But apart from the things that I would like to see on it, it's a great vehicle. As I said, the rims, yeah, they work, but could have been a bit better, and as I said, if it had that classic Range Rover twin tip pointing out the side here, would have been ideal. But other than that, great mod. Out of leave it, download it, keep it, it's a keeper. It's definitely a keeper. It's a great vehicle, great fun to drive, and I can see myself having more fun with this truck in more episodes to come. Alrighty, until then guys, I will catch you later. Bye for now.